Afternoon, everyone. To those of you visiting us for the very first time, especially, we welcome you to our parish community, Our Lady of Mount Carmel Church. To those of you who are registered at Flagno, may otherwise prefer to use your cellular phone to follow along during the Mass. Your virtual worshiping has recently been emailed to you. Also, this Mass is being recorded onto our music ministry YouTube channel, which you can find later tonight in YouTube.com. Keywords OLMC Music Ministry. Those are the keywords, separate words. If you are a member of Flagno, you will receive a direct link to the recording later tonight. And as always, we ask that you share the link with those who are homebound, unable to be with us this weekend due to sickness. At this time, I kindly ask everyone to silence on mobile phones. As always, as a courtesy to those who may be engaged in private prayer, we ask everyone to minimize loud conversation in the moments leading up to Mass, as well as in the moments following the Mass. We thank you for your understanding. And today the Church celebrates the 17th Sunday in Ordinary Time, in Cycle Year A. Father Alex will lead us in our worship this evening, and our cantor will be Wayne Custo.
Good afternoon, everyone. It's good to be with you. And so we begin with, O God, beyond all praising, please stand.
The kingdom of God is essentially God's plan for mankind. To belong to the kingdom means to accept, to collaborate with God in the fulfillment of his plan. Our Sunday Eucharistic celebration is a constant reminder of the importance of God's kingdom and a renewed opportunity to make it grow in our hearts and in our communities. Today we offer this Eucharist for each one's intentions and needs. Coming together as God's family, let us ask the Lord's forgiveness, for He is full of gentleness and compassion. Lord, we often barter the preciousness of Your grace for material pleasures and satisfactions. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, in our decisions, we are often guided not by Your wisdom, but by the wrong priorities of a materialistic and hedonistic world. Christ, have mercy. Lord, we often reduce our appreciation of Your kingdom to just pray for its coming while neglecting to work for it. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Bestow in abundance Your mercy upon us, and grant that with You as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that have ever endured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, Your Son, who lives and reigns with You in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. The Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream at night. God said, "Ask something of me, and I will give it to you." Solomon answered, "O Lord, my God, You have made me, Your servant, king to succeed my father David, but I am a mere youth, not knowing at all how I serve You in the midst of the people whom You have chosen, a people so vast that it cannot be numbered or counted. Give Your servant, therefore, an understanding heart to judge Your people and to distinguish right from wrong. For who is able to govern this vast people of Yours?" The Lord was pleased that Solomon made this request. So God said to him, "Because you have asked for this, not for a long life for yourself, nor for riches, nor for the life of your enemies, but for understanding, so that you may know what is right. I do as you requested. I give you a heart so wise and understanding that there has never been anyone like you up to now. And after you, there will come no one to equal you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
He justified, he also glorified.
Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure buried in a field, which a person finds and hides again. And out of joy goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant searching for fine pearls. When he finds a pearl of great price, he goes and sells all that he has and buys it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net thrown into the sea, which collects fish of every kind. When it is full, they haul it ashore and sit down to put what is good into buckets. What is bad, they throw away. Thus it will be at the end of the age. The angels will go out and separate the wicked from the righteous and throw them into the fiery furnace, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. Do you understand all these things?" They answered, "Yes." And he replied, "Then every tribe who has been instructed in the kingdom of heaven is like the head of a household who brings from his storeroom both the new and the old." My dear friends, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, every morning we have every reason to thank and praise God. This is easy to see for those people who are simple and humble, the childlike people of the Beatitudes. Jesus praised the Heavenly Father for them. He said, "I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the childlike." These are the ones who have discovered the mysteries of the kingdom and who clearly see the wonders that God does at every moment of every day. But for people who are steeped in selfishness and worldly attractions, unfortunately, that is not the case. Their greed for material things and their insatiable egoistic desires made their eyes blind to the supernatural and heavenly realities, which are the true and lasting treasures. This is what Pope Saint John Paul II referred to when he said, "The greatest misfortune of this age is that people consider money as the highest good. The scourge of this present humanity is materialism. When it rules, the spiritual matters invariably disappear and the true and lasting treasures lose their value." If you recall, last Sunday we reflected on the terrible reality of hell, the unquenchable fire of eternal punishment. For this Sunday, let us fix our eyes on the infinitely priceless treasure of heaven. The Gospel today gives us three parables of the kingdom of God about heaven. Just as hell is not only a geographical place, but is rather the state of definitive self-exclusion from communion with God and the blessed, so also is heaven not really a physical place. Indeed, according to the Catechism of the Catholic Church, heaven is the ultimate end and fulfillment of the deepest human longings, the state of supreme, definitive happiness. In other words, if hell is the state of being away from God, heaven, on the other hand, is the state of being in the presence of God, or being with God. The good news is that even though we are still on earth, it is possible for us to have a taste and glimpse of heaven. This happens in and through Jesus, the true God in human flesh. You know, the early fathers of the church loved to refer to Jesus as the auto-basileia. Auto means self, and basileia means kingdom. Jesus himself, the kingdom of God. To enter the kingdom of God, therefore, is to enter into a relationship with Jesus. When we are with Jesus, we are in a state of supreme happiness, for we are with God. We are in heaven, our greatest treasure. Now, how do we come into direct contact with God while we are still here? How do we get some taste and glimpse of heaven on earth? You know, the great Pope Benedict XVI said, and I quote, "The liturgy is the act in which we believe that God enters our lives, that we touch Him. We come into contact with God. He comes to us and we are illumined by Him. In a very unique and special way, Jesus is really present in the liturgy, especially in the Holy Eucharist." And Pope St. John Paul II said, "The liturgy we celebrate on earth, a mysterious participation in the heavenly liturgy." He further said that in fact, it is the eternal worship of heaven, but it is also steeped in time. You know, famous biblical scholar in the United States named Dr. Scott Hahn said, and I quote, "When Jesus comes again at the end of time, He will not have a single drop more glory than He has right now upon the altars and in the tabernacles of our churches. God dwells among mankind right now because the Mass is heaven on earth." Quote and quote. And St. John Chrysostom attested to this truth when he said that when Mass is celebrated, the sanctuary is filled with countless angels who adore the divine victim immolated on the altar. My dear friends, in the Gospel this Sunday, the man who found the buried treasure in a field sold everything he had in order to buy that field. The merchant who found the pearl of great price sold everything in order to buy it. And Jesus is talking about the priceless value of heaven, that one can readily sacrifice everything just to possess it. My question to you today is this, or for all of us, can we let go of our valued possessions in favor of heaven? Are we willing to invest all our hard-earned savings of a lifetime on the Lord's promise of eternal glory in heaven? But heaven is not just some abstract idea. Heaven is real, for it is Jesus himself, and Jesus is here with us in the Mass. Are we ready to leave behind our tasks at home just to be here at Mass on Sunday? Are we ready to sacrifice that baseball game or forget about that cold beer with our friends and taste the sweetness of heaven here in the Mass with Jesus? Is that beach party next Sunday more interesting than the experience of heaven on earth in the Holy Mass? This is something we have to think about very seriously. We are Catholics. We have the fullness of the truth. We have all the sacraments instituted by our Lord Jesus Christ. And we encounter and receive Jesus really present in the Holy Eucharist. Unfortunately, many of us take our Catholic faith for granted. We often tend to neglect Sunday Mass, and this is very, very sad. You know, the great saint, Saint Anselm, said, "A single Mass offered to oneself during life may be worth more than 1,000 celebrated for the same intention after death." Saint Margaret of the Sacred Heart bewailed the people's lack of reverence towards the Holy Eucharist. "Ah, what continual irreverence he receives from man in his own house," she said. "In his humility he deigns to dwell in our midst, yet how often is he neglected and forgotten, left in empty churches, while in his turn he never grows weary of this lonely vigil. Truly love is not love." My dear friends, let us ask God to continually grant us the gift of wisdom, like the one granted to Solomon, and to open the eyes of our faith so that each time we come to Mass, we will be able to see the infinite beauty and priceless value of it, despite the distractions and limitations of this material world. May we eagerly look forward to every Sunday or every day as a great blessing and a precious opportunity for us to encounter Jesus in the Holy Eucharist and have a taste of heaven here on earth and begin to enjoy eternal happiness now and for eternity. We now profess our faith. I believe in one God,
Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father of holiness, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten and made consubstantial of the Father. To him all things were made. For us men and for salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified in the Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have him. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen. With gratitude to the Lord for having called us to belong to the kingdom without any merit on our part, let us ask for all the other blessings that we need in order to become worthier members of his kingdom. Let us all say together.
Please respond, may your kingdom come, that the church may always be open to welcome all those who ask to be admitted, in order that they may gradually become faithful disciples of the Lord. Let us pray.
May your kingdom come.
That the Holy Father, the bishops, the priests, and the religious may succeed in inspiring us to love and serve the Lord with all our heart, all our mind, and all our soul. Let us pray.
May your kingdom come.
The parents, teachers, and catechists may lead their children and students to appreciate the importance of belonging to God's kingdom. Let us pray.
May your kingdom come.
That the homeless, the unemployed, the sick, and the marginalized may find in their Christian communities the compassion, solidarity, and generosity they need to experience. Let us pray.
May your kingdom come.
That the members of our community, especially the youth, may all receive the abundance of God's blessings and his confidence. successful in their efforts to invite many people to enter God's kingdom, let us pray.
May your kingdom come.
For those who have died, especially Bertha Bunaski, whom we remember in a special way, and the recently deceased, may they live forever with Christ in the glory of the resurrection, we pray.
May your kingdom come.
Let us pray in silence for our personal intentions. We pray.
May your kingdom come.
Lord Jesus, healer of body and souls, look with compassion on our community and on the whole world. May we inherit the kingdom where you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. As we prepare our hearts and minds to receive our sweet Jesus, we say, seek ye first.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which you bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we are blamed. Saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, let us offer each other the sign of Jesus, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
For those at home who are unable to receive the body and blood, soul and divinity of our Lord Jesus, we offer this prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Mother.
As we approach the altar, humbly to receive our sweet Jesus, we say, be not afraid.
Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which He Himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Can you be seated for a moment for some parish announcements? From the birthplace of our Lord Jesus Christ in Bethlehem, in Israel, the Christian community is seeking your love and support through obtaining their handmade olive wood religious articles. These items will be displayed at the church vestibule and outside after all masses the weekend of August 12 and 13. Your help can and will make a difference in the lives of our brothers and sisters in Bethlehem. Registration for religious education classes is still open. Please stop by the rectory to fill out the registration form or download it from our website and send it in to the rectory. The Women's Auxiliary is hosting a 3P3 fundraiser. The date is Friday, September 15. Doors are open at 6 p.m. Please check the bulletin boards in each side entrance of the church for further information. I'd like to remind you that next Sunday, August 6th, is the first Sunday of the month. And as always, the first Sunday of the month, we have coffee and conversation at the Le Garage Cafe. So please come and join us in our social event. You can bring your coffee, cake, whatever you may want to bring. Bring them on and share it with others. As you know, for those who don't know, every first Sunday of the month, we have coffee and conversation at the Le Garage Cafe. Every afternoon until 1:30 in the afternoon, we will be serving coffee and cake. Special announcement. When I became pastor of Our Lady Mount Carmel, one of the concerns brought to me by people, mostly parishioners, was about the difficulty of traffic in between Harrison Street and Prospect Street. Although this does not concern us directly as a church, but in some way it is, because this was a concern and still a concern of our parishioners who come to our church for church services. So last year, to the help of Mr. Woody Carmona, our emissary, I had a meeting with Mayor Joseph Scarpelli here in our church, and Sal, the person in charge of installing traffic signs in Notley. During that meeting, I voiced out to Mayor Scarpelli about my concerns and the concerns of our parishioners. So I just suggested to him if he could possibly install a stoplight or flashing light near the corner of Harrison Street and Prospect Street. After that meeting, I did not hear from him anymore until last month, when I saw some people from the town installing the flashing light at the corner of Harrison Street and Prospect Street. It took them for some time to make the flashing light work, but they did, and I'm so happy and grateful. So in the name of Mount Carmel Parish, I'd like to publicly acknowledge and thank Mayor Joseph Scarpelli for fulfilling his promise. You have done a great job, Mayor Joe. We thank you for this public service which you have rendered to us and to our parishioners. Please give him a hand of applause. Tomorrow, we invite you all our parishioners of Our Lady Mount Carmel and friends, for the blessing and cutting of the ribbons near the flashing light at the corner of Harrison Street and Prospect Street. Today, tomorrow, after the 9:15 p.m. Mass, say about 10:30 a.m. So let's join me with good Mayor for this blessing and special ceremony tomorrow here in between Prospect Street and Harrison Street. Isn't it the good news?
Yes.
Yes. My second special announcement. As some or most of you have seen it by now, we just erected the biggest and possibly the tallest religious statue in the town of Notley. It is a massive statue made of marble, about 8.5 feet in height, including the base. It is erected at the lawn at the right-hand corner of our church, facing Harrison Street. After a year long of waiting and after some setbacks, Our statue was finally delivered to us last Wednesday, July 26, the Feast of Saints Joaquin and Anna. The statue was procured from Fine's Gallery Internet LLC in Bonita Springs, Florida. But the statue itself was made outside the country. The statue weighed about 2,324 pounds. From the start of our negotiation till its delivery, it took about 6 months of waiting. As I promised to you, we will have our statue erected in our parish sooner or later, and we did. At this time, I'd like already to thank you again, especially those who extended your support and financially or otherwise. This project would not have been pursued and finalized without your support and help. As I promised before, once we get the statue, we will have a parish celebration and a blessing of the statue. So please, please mark your calendar. On August 26th, that's the last Saturday of August, a month from now, we will have a parish celebration here at Our Lady Mount Carmel to thank the Lord for his blessing. It will be a whole day of it. The details of the celebration and blessing will follow. I'll try to invite some of our civil authorities and our church authorities to come and celebrate with us on that day. So please mark your calendar, August 26th, Saturday, a month from now. We will have our celebration and blessing of our statue. I have sent already some feeds and blurbs at the Natalie Sons. I hope they will publish my article. And I have sent images already of our big statue. It's been the top of the tunnel. Thanks be to God. But thank you for all your prayers and for your support. Please stand. The Lord be with you. Bow your hands and pray for God's blessings. After his invocation, you respond, Amen. May the Lord give you the superior wisdom you need to value his kingdom more than anything else in life.
Amen.
May he give you the moral strength to reject anything that is incompatible with the values of the kingdom.
Amen.
May he reward your faithfulness to him by admitting you to his kingdom in its perfection in heaven.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
We continue on our journey. First, we sing to Jesus Christ, our Sovereign Lord.